Welcome to the lecture on the implementation of simple linear regression using R. In this lecture, we are going to see how to implement simple linear regression in R. As a part of this lecture, we are also going to look at how to load the data from a text file, how to plot the data, how to build a linear regression model, and how to interpret the summary of the model. Now, let's see how to load the data. Now, you have been given the data set bonds in the text format. The extension of the file is .txt. To load the data from the file, we use the function read.delim. So, read.delim reads a file in a table format and creates a data frame out of it. The input arguments to the function are file and row.names. Now, file is the name of the file from which you want to read the data, and row.names are essentially the row IDs. It can be a vector of names or only a single number corresponding to the column name. Now, assuming that the data is in your current working directory, the command reads as read.delim. So, within quotes, I have bonds.txt and I am giving row.names equal to 1. Now, once the command is executed, an object of bonds is created, which is a data frame. Now, let's see how to view the data. View of bonds will display the data in a tabular format. The snippet below shows the table. We can also view the first few rows of any data set. Head and tail functions will help us to do that. Now, head of bonds will give us the first 6 rows from the data, and tail of bonds will give us the last 6 rows from the data. Now, let's look at the description of the data set. Now, the data has 2 variables, coupon rate and bid price. Now, coupon rate refers to the fixed interest rate that the issuer pays to lender. Bid price is the price someone is willing to pay for the bond. Now, we've seen how to load the data and how to view the data. Let's now see what the structure of the data is. By structure, I mean that each variable and its data type. We use the function str and the input to the function is a data frame. Now, we exactly want to see whether the variable data type are same as what we expected them to be. If not, we need to coerce them to the respective data types. So, now this should ring a bell because we've learned the function as dot followed by the name of the data type, and we will use this function to coerce it if the variable is not of the desired type. Now, for this data set, I run the function. I say str of bonds. Now, bonds is the name of my data frame. So, the output reads as data frame, bonds is of the type data frame. It has 35 observations of 2 variables. The first column being coupon rate, which is of the type numeric, and I have the first few values being displayed. The next column, bid price, is also of the type numeric, and the first few values of the same column are being displayed. Now, let's look at the summary of the data. So, the summary function followed by the name of the data frame, in this case bonds, will give us five number summary and mean from the data. Now, the first column, which is coupon rate, I have the five number summary and the mean, and I also have the five number summary and the mean for the second column. So, till now, we have seen how to load the data, how to view the data. We have also looked at the structure and the summary. Now, let's see how to visualize the data. So, to visualize the data, I use the plot function. We have covered the plot function earlier in the visualization in R section. Now, the input to the plot function are basically x and y. In this case, x refers to my coupon rate and y refers to my bid price. So, in order to access the variables, I need to give the name of the data frame followed by a dollar symbol. So, I say access coupon rate from the bonds data and access bid price from the bonds data. So, I can also give a title to my plot. So, inside the parameter main, you can specify the title of your plot. Xlab is nothing but X label. So, I am assigning it as coupon rate, and Y label, I am assigning it as bid price. So, the plot is on right hand side. So, the title is bid price versus coupon rate, like how we have assigned it. On the Y axis, I have bid price, and I have labeled it as bid price, and on the x axis I have coupon rate and I have labeled it as coupon rate. Now, we see a linear trend. Now, there are some points which are completely outside the range of coupon rate. Now, let's see if our linear model will help us to identify these points. So, to start with, let's build a linear regression model. So, building a linear model is done using the function lm. So, the inputs for the function are formula and data. By formula, I mean I am regressing dependent variable versus the independent variable. So, how is it translated to a formula? So, I have dependent variable, I have a tillet sign followed by the independent variable. So, the tillet sign tells us regress the dependent variable with the independent variable. So, there are two ways to build a linear model. Let's see how to do that. The first way tells us linear model, which is a function. So, I am accessing the individual variables, which is bit price and coupon rate, using the data frame followed by the dollar symbol. So, take bit price from the bonds data and take coupon rate from the bonds data and regress them. There is also another way. So, instead of mentioning the name of the data frame to access the variables, we can directly mention the name of the variable and give data equal to bonds. So, access these variables from the bonds data. So, assuming our equation is of the form yi hat equal to beta naught hat plus beta 1 hat xi plus epsilon I. So, epsilon I is the error, which will be called as residuals. So, beta naught hat is the intercept and beta 1 hat is the slope. So, hereafter these estimates will be referred to as intercept and slope. So, now that we have built a linear model and have saved it as an object bonds mod, let's see how to fit the regression line over the plot. We will use a function called AB line and the input for the function is bonds mod, which is my linear model. Now, we've already gone back and seen how to plot coupon rate and bid price. Now, in addition to the plot, you need to mention this command. So, AB here refers to the intercept and slope. If your equation is of the form y equal to A plus BX, then A is my intercept and B is my slope. In this case, A is beta naught hat and B is beta 1 hat. So, let's see how the plot looks. So, on my right, I have the plot. We are now able to see how the regression line fits. It fits pretty badly and it's also not identify the outlier. So, we can say that the regression line is indeed getting affected by these outliers. So, now let's take a look at the model summary. So, I have regressed bid price versus coupon rate from the data bonds. You can also use the other command. So, summary is the function. The input to the summary function becomes the linear model. So, we have bonds mod as the linear model. This is the first look at the summary. So, this is how it looks when you run the command and this is how it would look in the console. So, we have four sections of output. We have call, we have residual, we have coefficients and we have some few heuristics at the bottom. So, now let's look at each of these and what they mean in depth. Now, call displays the formula which we have used. So, in this case, I have used the formula bid price versus coupon rate. So, regress bid price, which is my dependent variable, with my independent variable, which is coupon rate, and from the data bonds. Now, this is a way for you to check if you have given the right dependent and independent variable. The next section is residual. So, what are residuals? Residuals are nothing but difference between the observed and predicted values. So, in our equation, earlier we saw we had a parameter called epsilon I. So, that epsilon I corresponds to residuals. Below the residuals is the fine number summary for the residual. So, the next section is coefficients. We see two rows, which is intercept and coupon rate, and certain set of values associated with them. Now, these intercept and coupon rate are nothing but beta naught hat and beta 1 hat. We earlier saw for our equation y equal to beta naught hat plus beta 1 hat into xi plus epsilon I. Beta naught hat is the intercept and beta 1 hat is the slope. Now, let's see what other four parameters in the column have to say. Now, I have the first column, which is estimate. Now, this is nothing but the estimate for the slope and intercept parameter. The next column is standard error. So, standard error is the estimated standard deviation associated for the slope and intercept. I have the next column as t value. So, what is t value? It is the ratio of estimate by the standard error, and it is also an important criterion for the hypothesis testing. The column after that is the probability. So, it is the probability of seeing a t random variable which will be greater than the observed t statistic. So, we can see few stars being indicated at the end. So, what are these stars? These stars tell us the significance level above which the null hypothesis will be rejected. So, what is the null hypothesis? The null hypothesis is that the estimates will be equal to 0. At the last line, I have an F statistic and a corresponding p value associated with it. Now, the F statistic is again used to test the null hypothesis, which is nothing but slope equal to 0. So, in this lecture, we saw how to load a data, how to plot and how to visualize, how to build a linear model and how to interpret the results from the linear model. So, in the next lecture, we will see how to assess our model and we will see if we can improvise our model. Thank you.